your fucking mind. Okay. So now a block mountain, as you all can see, even over here. Okay, just let me bring it up. Even here. Okay. So isme kya hota hai? This both now the land is basically flat. Land mein sabse pehle flat hi rehta hai. It's not like एक ऊपर एक नीचे रहता है ऐसा लैंड नहीं बनता लैंड इज बेसिकली फ्लैट बट व्हेन द टेंशन इज कॉज्ड फ्रॉम द अंडरग्राउंड से द टेंशन आता है दैट्स व्हाई दिस पार्ट इज कॉल्ड एज अ हॉर्स दैट्स व्हाई दिस पार्ट कम्स अप ओके बेसिकली इट गेट्स अ पुश नीचे से कोई उसको धक्का मारता है दैट्स व्हाई इट कम्स अप ओके दिस इज योर नॉर्मल सो इसका बाजू का यू ऑल कैन दिस पार्ट इज प्लेन बट व्हाई दिस पार्ट इज अप बिकॉज़ देयर इज अ टेंशन नीचे से उनको धक्का मारा दैट्स व्हाई इट्स कम अप Okay, even in this, you can see either ka part plain hai. It's a support. It's nothing. Upar nahi, niche nahi. But only this part is up. Why? Because the tension it forced the land to go up. Okay. Four mountains are formed due to compression. Compression matlab instead of pulling it, they compressed it. Dono ko ekdam pass mein laya. Okay. So even when you take, okay, for example, this paper. Okay. You all can see this paper. Now I'm compressing it. Okay. You all can see folds bana dikh raha hai tum logo yahan pe. Okay, so this is the same way the mountain was formed. The next is just an example, the Black Forest Mountains of Europe, as soon as I showed you all the photo. And the fold mountain ka example is the Himalayan or the Arabian. Okay, just understand this. You all don't have to write this. Next is the secondary wave and the primary wave and the secondary wave. Primary waves are the first one to reach the surface of the earth. Okay, I'll show you all the diagram over here. So you all can see the waves over here. Okay, the primary wave, secondary waves, and the third one is the surface waves. So primary waves with its name. So you all have gone to primary and secondary, right? You all went through primary and now you all are in secondary. Primary was which standard?
First
standard. First to fourth. Absolutely correct. Okay. So first two was primary. So you had to go through primary, then you all went to secondary. The same way, this may be for the earthquake to come. First primary waves are there. Okay. Primary waves they come and they reach the earth surface. After that, the secondary waves come. Then the last wave that's called as the surface waves. When the surface waves hits the earth, that's when earthquakes take place. Okay. उसके पहले before the earthquakes hit land इधर थोड़ा हिलता डुलता है ना. That is because the primary and secondary wave. Okay. Let us go back here. Now primary waves they can travel through solid, liquid, and gaseous medium. Okay, we have already done this. I'm just revising it. They can travel through solid, liquid, and gaseous medium. And the secondary waves can only travel through solid medium. That means they can only travel through rocks or they can only travel through buildings. Others they cannot travel through anything else. Okay, next. While traveling through liquid medium, primary changes their direction. Okay, so when you're going, okay, now अभी तुम लोग see if you're walking on a road, okay, तुम लोग रास्ते में साइकिल चला रहे So, तुम लोग रास्ते में साइकिल चला रहे पर आगे रास्ता ही नहीं है आगे खाई है तो तुम लोग ऊपर जंप तुम लोग सलमान खान के ऊपर जंप मार के तुम लोग दूसरे साइड पे जाएंगे नहीं ऑब्वियसली यू विल चेंज योर डायरेक्शन ओके द सेम वे प्राइमरी वेव्स एज दे पास थ्रू थिंग्स इफ दे सी एन ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन वो लोग के सामने दे चेंज देयर डायरेक्शन द सेकेंडरी वेव्स गेट ऑब्जर्व्ड एज दे एंटर द लिक्विड मीडियम सो दीज वेव्स गेट ऑब्जर्व्ड दे डोंट चेंज डायरेक्शन यू हैव सीन स्पंज Oh, you'll have seen, agar tum log koi plant ko if you all could water it, it gets observed, right? The same way secondary waves also get observed. The fourth point, the waves move in to and fro direction. Now, who can tell me what are to and fro direction? You did yesterday only. Who can tell me what are to and fro?
Forwards and backwards.
Absolutely correct. To move forward and backward is called as to and fro. And the secondary waves, they go from up to down direction. Basically, upar niche. That's why during the earthquake, everything हम अपने आजू बाजू का सब हिलने लगता है आगे पीछे पे जाता है ऊपर नीचे जाता है ओके एवरी वन क्लियर टिल यू एनी डाउट्स नेक्स्ट
नो सर
नेक्स्ट वीक ओके वेरी गुड टोटो नाइस डीपी इज योर कैट देयर वाज अ डॉग था ना देयर
नहीं मेरा बिल्ली नहीं है
अच्छा नेक्स्ट इज अर्थक्वेक्स एंड वोल्केनोस ओके नाउ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अर्थक्वेक एंड वोल्केनोस व्हेन अर्थक्वेक हैपेंस The earth breaks. Okay, the surface layer of the earth breaks and building girta niche. Volcano mein kuch girta nahi. Volcano it gives lava bahar fekta. Okay, like a dragon. Like lava bahar fekta and uske aaju baju ka jo bhi cheez sabko jala deta. Earthquake is the moments of the earth crust. A volcano is the opening in the earth crust. Okay, earthquake mein kya hota hai? Pura the ground starts shaking, but in a volcano nothing shakes. Volcano ka jo upper ka jo conical mouth hai, udhar se lava nikal. नेक्स्ट नथिंग इज इजेक्टेड आउट ड्यूरिंग एन अर्थक्वेक के टाइम पे कुछ जमीन जमीन से लावा निकलता है क्या नहीं उल्टा जो बिल्डिंग है वो जमीन के अंदर जाता है सो नथिंग इज कमिंग आउट ऑफ द अर्थ बट ड्यूरिंग ड्यूरिंग अ वोल्केनो ऐश वाटर लावा गैसेस हॉट मोल्टन जो लावा इज नॉट अदर पानी नहीं है ना हाथ उसको हाथ डुबका के आगे तुम लोग ने जल जाएगा तुम लोग का हाथ सो ऑल दोस थिंग्स दे कम आउट फ्रॉम द वोल्केनो दिस इज अ वेरी इजी वन ओके Now give reasons why earthquake occurs. Okay, so I'll have to tell why does an earthquake occur. First is when earthquake movements occur in the when the abhi basically I'll give you a very good example. Okay, so I'll give this example when you're late. तुम लोग का पेट पूरा भरा रहता है और तुम लोग ऐसा bus में travel करते हैं. See mostly तुम लोग school में picnic जाते हैं. You all don't sit bus के ending seat में. Why? Because some people tend to vomit. क्योंकि गोल-गोल घूमते तो उल्टी आ जाए उसमें से. Okay. That's the same way. So when the earth ke pet mein jab gudgud hota hai na, so when the earth vomits, that's the earthquake. Okay. The next is when the tension goes beyond the limit. Okay. So even like a rubber band. Okay. Tum log rubber band ko beat sakte. You all can pull it till a certain limit. But obviously there's a certain limit. Now after that limit, the rubber band also breaks. Barabar. Tum log ko ye aake lagta hai. That the same way the earth also can take a certain limit. उसके अगर उसके limit से ज़्यादा अगर earth को खींचा तो earthquake चालू होता है. ठीक है. Next is which type of movements have led to the formation of major fold mountains. Okay. Now mountains कैसे बनता है. Okay. I'll just anode and show you. This is a very easy. So now this is your land before anything. ठीक है. Are there any mountains? इसपे mountains है क्या नहीं. There's nothing over there. Okay. But क्या होता है. This is your earth. नीचे अर्थ है दिस इज योर अर्थ का इनर लेयर सरफेस सो व्हाट हैपेंस इधर से ऊपर प्रेशर आ रहा है. ठीक है. तो अभी क्या हो गया इधर प्लेन है पर इधर प्रेशर आ रहा है तो इधर माउंटेन आ गया. इधर प्लेन है इधर प्रेशर आ रहा है इधर माउंटेन आ गया. द सेम वे इधर प्लेन है इधर प्रेशर आ गया तो इधर माउंटेन आ गया. सो दीज माउंटेन्स गेट ये व्हेन दे फॉर्म इन 2000. ओके. दे वर फॉर्मड इन 2000. नाउ इज 2020. नाउ ऑब्वियसली 20 इयर्स के बाद ऑब्वियसली देयर आर सम मोर डिफरेंसेस ना. तो बेसिकली नाउ अभी इधर माउंटेन हो गया सो प्रेशर पड़ के वो माउंटेन बढ़ने वाला है क्या नहीं. सो वेदर जिधर गैप है ना बेसिकली दिस इज प्लेन. सो इधर प्रेशर रख के इधर एक छोटा माउंटेन बनेगा फिर अभी इधर एक छोटा माउंटेन इधर. सो इससे क्या होता है माउंटेन्स का एक पूरा हिल का रेंज बन जाता है. एक रेंज जैसा बिल्डिंग तुम लोग का एक सोसाइटी रहता है चार पांच बिल्डिंग का वैसे माउंटेन्स का भी एक छोटा सा रेंज बन जाता है. ओके. सो यू ऑलवेज अंडरस्टैंड दिस यू ऑल कैन राइट दिस इन द होमवर्क सो यू डोंट हैव टू इतना लिखने का जरूरत नहीं. ठीक है. How is the magnitude of the earthquake related to the collapse of houses? Okay. Now, how do we see the magnitude of an earthquake? I told you all that there's a tool which is used. Anyone remembers that tool ka naam? We had done this. You all have written also. Starts with an S. Anyone? Kisko yaad nahi? Arre likha hai tum log ne? Kya ki bol rahe ho?
Sir, I know the tool, but I don't know the pronunciation of that.
Okay. I'll say it. It's called as a seismogram. Okay, seismogram. So what does this tool do? Okay, I'll just show you all the seismogram once again. Okay. So see this. Okay, let. So see, this is like a seismogram. So this is how it works. So when there's plane, okay, when there's nothing happening, like pura, like now as of now, okay, abhi earthquake nahi aa raha. So it is plane. But when earthquake comes, na, this seismogram pe there's a meter that starts working and ekdam upar niche ho jata. So we know how much earthquake, okay. Also here. So now you all can see isme. Now you all can see there are different colors of lines, okay. So basically the blue line is like see if this short lines are called as primary waves and the big lines are called as secondary waves because obviously the primary ones are the smaller waves and the secondary ones are the bigger waves. Okay. So this is a part of seismogram. So the seismogram helps to generate how much magnitude. So you all see the magnitude kitna aata earthquake ka. It is like a 9.0 or 2.0 magnitude. That is because of seismogram. After studying this graph, the magnitude of the earthquake is known. The magnitude of the earthquake is measured with the help of a Richter scale. Okay, you all can write this down. Just write this one line down. Okay, the magnitude is with the help of Richter scale, because this can come with your MCQ also. Let me know once you're done writing, okay?
Sir, only that point?
Yeah, only that point, only that point. Let me know once you're done. For the understanding, now you can write the answer in the homework. Any doubts in this? You can write the answers. If you all have doubts, anything, you can come and ask me again. Because this chapter is an important chapter. So I don't want you all to miss out on anything. I'll send the PDF with the explanation itself. So you all will have this. So if you have doubt, then you all can ask me later also. Okay? Nonetheless, it is because of the primary waves that the building of the earth surfaces move back and forth. The building of the earth surfaces move up and down because of the secondary waves. These are more destructive than the T waves. T waves are known as the surface waves, leading to the collapse, obviously. So when... One second. So when the waves hit the earth, okay, which two waves hit the earth? The primary waves and the secondary waves, okay? So primary waves goes how? Up and up, up, down, up, to and fro. How does primary waves go? Upar, niche, ki, aage, piche?
Aage, piche.
Aage, piche, absolutely correct. So they go to and fro. So primary waves ka issue and nahi. Secondary waves, they go up and down, okay? So if agar main building ko upar, niche, dhakla, so obviously gir jayega na, building doesn't have so much power. So that's why. So during an earthquake, the secondary waves are the waves that are reasonable. Sorry, okay. What is the word? I'm not getting that word. The secondary waves can be blamed for the falling of buildings. Okay, because when the secondary waves hit the earth surface, they go up and down. Okay, that's the reason that the building collapses. Next one. What are the effects? What are the effects of the earthquake on the earth's surface and human life? Okay, so this is like a proper general question. Tum log bhi likh sakte. Aisa nahi ki this has to be textual only. You all can answer it. Okay. First, the cracks and fractures develop on the ground. Obviously, earthquake ke baad there are cracks on the ground. You all can. Wo cracks ko fevi ke laake chipkega to nahi chipkega. Obviously, it takes time to develop it again. This causes landslide, which leads to sliding of rock. When the earth is shaking, obviously the mountains also, some mountains break. Okay, sometimes the groundwater changes course. The groundwater example, your well. Okay, abhi earthquake time agar well toot gaya, so groundwater bhi nikal jayega. You all won't get that water again. Okay, tsunamis are generated in the ocean. This can cause a great life. So after the earthquake, when the earth shakes, not only the surface, also the water level shakes. So because of that, what happens? Sometimes a tsunami comes. And tsunami comes, so you all know, people die during tsunami. Okay? The next one. Now, explain the types of seismic waves. Okay, so this is an important answer. Just pay attention. Okay? So, you all have to explain the type, the three different types of waves. That is the P waves, that is the primary waves, S waves, secondary waves, and the third one are surface layers waves, that is the T waves. Okay? The first are primary waves. We have done this 100 of times. I'll said one more again. The first waves to reach the surface of the earth is called as the primary waves. They travel through liquid, solid and gas. Meko to bahar ho gaya. Okay? They travel through solid, liquid and gas and they move in which direction? To and fro. So what do you have to say? The primary waves is also known as P waves. They are the first one to reach the surface of the earth. They can travel through three states. That is solid, liquid and gas. And the movement, they move from to and fro. Okay, primary waves understood by everyone. Any doubt in primary waves, guys?
No, sir.
Okay. Next are secondary waves. Okay. After the primary waves come the secondary waves. Okay. These are larger waves. These waves are bigger than the primary waves. and they scatter it up and downward direction. They don't go aage piche, wo log upar nahi jaate. Okay, and these can only travel through solid medium. Agar liquid form mein gaya, they get absorbed. So they only can travel through solid medium. So secondary waves are the bigger waves. They reach after the primary wave, so they are the second and they are bigger. They go in which direction? Up and down direction, and they can only travel through solid medium. They cannot travel through a liquid medium. Okay, and the last one is surface waves. The surface wave is the last wave because it's the last type of wave experienced by Earth that jiske karan earthquake hota hai. These mainly reach the surface after the primary and secondary waves. And they travel through the Earth's crust. Okay, they don't travel in liquid and solid. Ye log seedha Earth ka jo ground hai wo phad ke nikal jaate. Okay, basically. Next is okay. Now we've seen the three types of waves. These two questions. Explain the types of seismic waves and explain the types of volcanoes. These two questions are the most important question. Okay. Now explain the types of volcanoes. The first are active volcanoes. Okay. Now what are active volcanoes? Active volcanoes मतलब which कभी भी फट सकता है. Okay. मतलब there's a chance that उसमें से lava निकल के कभी फट सकता है. Okay. If the volcano eruptions are regular in the present times, then such volcanoes are called as active volcanoes. Basically, the volcano that can कभी भी फट सकता है is called as an active volcano. Dormant volcano मतलब मरा हुआ volcano. उसको फट मतलब अभी वो मतलब हो गया 10-15 साल हो गया. It's not blown up. It's not erupted. Means it's dead. मतलब हो गया उसका अंदर का लावा खत्म हो गया. Like it's done. अभी वो वापस नहीं आ सकता. So that's called as a dormant volcano. The next is extinct volcanoes. These volcanoes which are not erupted in a long time, okay, and are not likely to erupt in the future are called the extinct volcanoes. Basically, extinct volcanoes ये कभी के जमाने के ये dinosaur के जमाने के volcanoes थे, ठीक है? वो लोग एक बार फट के हो गया. अभी वो लोग हो गया. They are extinct. So now what happens? People go over there for trekking. Okay, like Mount Kilimanjaro in Tanzania, Brazil. People go there for trekking to see how the volcanoes work. You can't go on a live volcano. Live volcano में तुम लोग you can go actually. There are some. So you all know the Northern Lights. You all have seen the Northern Lights. You all have heard about it. I'll show you all. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I want to go over there, but I'll show you all. Okay. So see, this is a place. This is a place where you can go, and in the sky you all can see this type of lights. Okay. This is a real. This is not an edited image. This is a real image. So to go over here, now you have to pass a volcano, okay, an active volcano you can pass. So usme kaisa hai kya usme, sorry, where I went, usme there's a particular path. Okay, I don't have the photo, I'll just draw and show you. So if this is the volcano, there's a particular path we have to cross by, and the path is marked. Okay, so the people, they have to go through this mark only. Agar log idhar pair rakha unka pair jal jayega. It's still active, ठीक है? वो पिछले 10-15 साल से फूटा नहीं है, पर because of the lava, अभी लावा को ठंडा नहीं होता, लावा को फ्रिज में नहीं रहता था अपन ना, तो गर्म ही रहता है. So because of that, only this part is not available to walk. इधर पैर रखा, पैर जल जाता है. मतलब पैर जलेगा नहीं, बट योर शूज है ना, तुम लोग का शू पिघलने लगेगा, एंड वो इतना गर्म रहता है. Okay, so this was the extinct volcano. And the last one is a diagram. This diagram is a very important diagram. It shows you everything. It shows the epicenter. It shows the Earth surface wave, the primary wave, secondary waves, and the focus and the epicenter and upar ka. So you all have to draw this. So I don't want you all to draw this upar niche ka. This is like the destruction thing. It's optional to you all. So if you all want to draw, you all can draw that. But I want this part, this niche ka part, and the focus where the primary wave, secondary waves, and all the return. I want that for you all to draw. Okay, so I'll understood. Idhar tak samjha sabko? Any doubts in this?
No, sir.
Okay. So no, sir. Let me just tell you. Okay, so I'll tell you all. Kidhar se yeah. So yesterday, tum log kidhar tak likha tha tum log ne?
I think question number 5.
Ye likha tha na tum log ne? Volcanic eruptions.
Ha.
Okay. So now we just forgot to do this part. So I'll just quickly do it. Identify the name internal movements. Okay, so sudden movement and sudden slow movement and sudden movements. For those who are absent, let me do a quick recap. What are sudden movements? What are slow movements? Slow movements basically which take time. Okay, so Aaron, you want to explain to you once again. Slow movements basically which take time. So you know a building of a mountain. or even a building. Can a building be made in one day? No. Okay. So those are slow movements. Sudden movements are movements bina bol ke aa jate. Means you don't know when it will come. Okay. Like rain. Rain tells you what when it's coming. No. वो सडनली गिर जाता है. इवन थंडर सडनली गिर जाता है. दोज आर सडन मूवमेंट्स. ओके सो सुनामी आर जनरेटेड इन क्वेश्चन एरिया. दोज आर व्हाट सडन मूवमेंट्स. मोल्टन मैग्मा इज थ्रोन आउट ऑफ द अर्थ बेसिकली अ वोल्केनो इरप्शन इज अ सडन मूवमेंट. द हिमालयज एन एग्जांपल ऑफ फोल्ड माउंटेन इज अ स्लो बिकॉज हिमालय एक दो दिन में नहीं बना. हिमालय को बनने को टाइम लगा. एंड द लास्ट मूवमेंट इज रिफ्ट वैली इज फॉर्म बिकॉज ऑफ फॉल्टिंग दैट्स ऑल्सो स्लो. ओके सो फ्रॉम हियर this itna at least 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 I think there are 7 to 8 slides which you all have for homework. Okay so I'm sending this right now. I'll just send it right now on the group. So by tomorrow afternoon give me a time till when you all will send it to me by tomorrow afternoon
sir. Tomorrow
aha tomorrow timing to bo to
so 5 o'clock
you will send it to me.
Sir before 12 o'clock
everyone tell me on particular time rate.
So 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock. Everyone is okay with 5 o'clock?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just give me one second. Sir. Okay. Just give me one second. I'll just share it on the group. So then we are. I'm done with that. Just give me one second. I'm just sharing the PPT on the group. So the PPT consists of the previous slides also in which I used for explanation. So if anyone has any doubt, they can go through that slides also. Last 9. Okay, just tell me if you all have received on WhatsApp. Just tell me if you all have got the message.
Yes, sir. Received.
Okay. So tomorrow before 5 o'clock, I need everyone's notebook or PDF of this chapter, endogenetic movement. Okay. So today I think we have only half an hour. Yeah. Who was that? Anyone saying something?
Sir, जो आपने PDF भेजा उसका सारे question answers लिखना
है? हाँ, पर ना टोटो हम लोग ने कल आधे लिखे हुए थे. You were present ना कल आप थे ना.
Yes.
तो जो लिखे हैं हाँ जो लिखे हैं वो मत लिखो. जो नहीं लिखे वो कंटिन्यू कर दो उसके आगे से. ठीक है एवरीवन डोंट राइट स्टार्टिंग से. यू ऑल हैव ऑलरेडी रिटन हाफ ऑफ इट. सो द पार्ट व्हिच यू ऑल हैव नॉट रिटन जस्ट कंटिन्यू दैट. ओके सो वी स्टार्ट विल स्टार्ट बिकॉज़ वी हैव हाफ एन आवर. सो आई स्टार्ट ऑफ विद अ न्यू चैप्टर ओनली. सो दिस इज एनीवन गेटिंग बोर. किसको बोर हो रहा है क्या? मैं सिखा रहा था इसलिए बोर हो रहा है किसको?
नो सर.
Okay, so I'll just start. We'll just start with a brief premise. I'll give you all of the next chapter. The chapter's name is called Post World War Political Development. That is the political science ka first chapter. Okay, Aaron, you also with them only. We are starting a new chapter, so you can also pay attention. We all on the same page. Okay, so post World War. What does this mean? Post World War.
Before World War.
वो तो pre World War हो जाएगा ना? Not freedom. It's like the opposite of freedom. What is the meaning of dependence?
To depend on someone else.
बराबर. The interdependence is the same thing. It means to depend on someone else. Okay. So basically, all the countries of the world are dependent on each other for one reason or the other. Okay. However prosperous or developed a nation may be, it can never be self-sufficient about its needs. Even big nations have to depend upon other big and small nations. So all the now we are talking about a nation. Okay. All nations, depend on other nations for something. Okay. We as India. Now, basically, COVID के time पे we are depending on other nations to send us vaccines. Okay, the same way before COVID, other nations were depending on India to send them what spices. Okay, we are depending on Dubai to send us oil. So each country is dependent on another country for something for some of the other reason. Okay, no country self मतलब there's no country की country हाथ ऊपर करके बोले यार मेरे पास सब कुछ है. ठीक है, पैसा वैसा सब कुछ है मेरे पास, तेल वेल सब कुछ है, ऐसा कोई कंट्री नहीं बोलेगा. ओके, एवरी कंट्री इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन एनी अदर कंट्री फॉर द स्मॉलेस्ट ऑफ रीजन. ओके, बट दैट कंट्री. सो आई कैन राइट दिस पॉइंट डाउन. तो दिस इज तुम लोग का इंटरडिपेंडेंस का एक तुम लोग का आंसर है सवाल का एट दिस पॉइंट का. Let me know when you are done so I can go ahead. I'm not going entirely in this chapter because there are few students absent, so they'll also miss it. So I'll just give you all a brief premise of the chapter. So then you'll just know that what we are going into. So by next lecture, by tomorrow lecture, we'll start again starting say, and we'll go proper into it, okay?
सर क्या बोला
आप? I'm saying that आज है ना, because दो तीन लोग absent भी है, so मैं एकदम सब ने सीखा है, मैं पूरा चैप्टर खत्म नहीं कर सकती क्योंकि आधा एक घंटा है आपके पास, तो मैं सिर्फ प्रीमाइस देगा, तुम लोग को एक ओवरव्यू देगा चैप्टर का, so तुम लोग भी समझ सकते हैं what we are going to study आप लोग. Yeah, this is a very brief and small chapter. It's very interesting. It's all about the World War. Okay, it's all about World War One, World War Two, and the Cold War. Anyone knows what is the Cold War? You all have heard about the Cold War? Anyone? I'm sure you all have heard about World War One, World War Two. Anyone, yes. Any idea what is Cold War? What is Cold War?
Sir, कोई तो दो countries के बीच में झगड़ा हुआ.
तो वो war हो गया ना वो. तो वो word क्यों दिया वहाँ पे? Cold क्यों बोला उसने? ठंडा है क्या वो? झगड़ा ठंडी में कर रहे झगड़ा क्या? There's a reason why they gave the word cold. We'll get to it.
All the countries are fighting?
No, it's not all the countries. It is between two countries only, but it's not a war. Okay, it's like, how can I tell you? A cold war is a war. Basically, वो लोग से बोलते हैं कि मैं तेरे को मारेगा, तू मेरे को मारेगा, but कोई मारता नहीं है. Okay, basically that. So it's the time before the war, but there was no war happening. It was just mind games basically. Everyone is done writing?
No, sir.
No. I don't want to give you all more writing today because तुम लोग को आज लिखने का है, आज हर बार लिखने का ही है. So I won't give you all more writing. You just write this one part, then I'll go ahead with the explanation.
सर बीच में से बनाओ क्या?
क्या क्या? मीनिंग ऑफ इंटरडिपेंडेंस. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन इज इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस. इवन इफ यू मिस्ड इट, डोंट वरी, बिकॉज टुमारो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द स्टार्टिंग अगेन. दिस इज एन ओवरव्यू. Even if I missed it, don't worry. Okay, international relations through foreign policies. Okay, every nation has policies about its internal dealing and also about its relation with other nations. Such a policy is called as a foreign policy. Basically, our relationships with our neighboring countries. Okay, now I know you know photo देख के बोलते हैं ये कैसा relationship है, तीन लोग उंगली दिखा रहे हैं, ठीक है? So basically that I just put an animation. So how we have relationship with Russia or USA. Okay. Now, सबके पास बंदूक है, everyone has an army. सब लोग झगड़ा करके बोल सकते हैं मैं आप पे, मतलब मैं बड़ा थे तू बड़ा ऐसा, ठीक है? But why do we keep this relationship? Okay, you all have seen students go from India to USA to study. India से लोग बाहर जाते पढ़ने के लिए, ठीक है? Why is it allowed? Though all those things are allowed only because of this foreign policy. okay? Even our trade, when we trade spices for something else. Even when this vaccine, when we accepted vaccine from different nations, those all came under foreign policies. Okay, so the relationship we have with foreign countries it comes under foreign policies. Okay, the next one is the first one. Okay, so now we okay. So wait, I went ahead. Yeah, one second. Why the screen stuck? Oh, background. So now before starting with the chapter, mein only there are three things that are spoken about. The First World War, the Second World War, and the Cold War. Okay, and the things after the Cold War ke baad kya hua? So this is the only three things you need to keep in mind. Okay, now first, the world in which we live today has been shaped through many events and developments. Hence, we need to go back in history in order to understand today's world. We know that two wars were fought in the last century. Century means what? A period of 100 years is called a century. Okay, a period of 100 years is called a century, and a period of 10 years is called a decade. Okay, if you all want, you all can write it. A period of 100 years, 100 years is equal to century, and 10 years is equal to decade. Tum logo 10th mein bahut baar aane wala hai. Theek hai, 9th mein bhi aayega, tum logo ending mein aayega, but you all need to remember 100 years is a century and 10 years is a decade. These were the most important events in the history of the world. The world completely changed because of them. No, you don't have to write this. I'm just explaining to you. Okay. So you all tell me, agar World War hota hi nahi tha, okay, World War II hota hai. Kitne World Wars hue? 5-6. Kitne hue tha abhi tak? Do. Absolutely correct. Two World Wars. No. Okay. So absolutely correct. So agar wo do World War hota hi nahi tha, to would we be staying as we are now? Would the world be the same? No. Obviously no. We would be under British ka rule only abhi tak. We can't say. ओके हम लोग को मालूम ही नहीं रहता भी हम लोग इंटरनेट फोन वोन कुछ रहता नहीं था. हम लोग जंगल में घूमते रहते थे, पकड़ा पकड़ी खेलते रहते थे, एक दूसरे को मार के खाते रहते थे. वी वुड नॉट नो ओनली व्हाट वाज गोइंग ऑन. ओके, बिकॉज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड वॉर द वर्ल्ड चेंज्ड इट्स कोर्स. ओके, अभी हम लोग जो है बिकॉज द पीपल हु डाइड इन द वर्ल्ड वॉर. ओके, नाउ डू वन थिंग, द मीटिंग इज एंडिंग, सो आई जस्ट एंड द मीटिंग एंड यू ऑल जॉइन द सेम लिंक अगेन, देन वी विल कंटिन्यू. ओके, जॉइन थ्रू द सेम लिंक अगेन.